George W. Bush has stayed far from the media spotlight since leaving office. This week, as all the living presidents gathered in Dallas for the dedication of his library, Bush granted a round of television interviews. But despite the best efforts of these journalists, the former president showed his skill at ducking questions.
Do you want people to look at some of the information you had, and do you think you'll convince the people who thought that was an unjust war, the wrong war at the wrong time, that perhaps you were right?
Look, the whole purpose is to lay out the facts as I saw them at the time. And people will make their own judgments. Some will agree, some will disagree.
One of the issues in the party in which there seems to be some shift taking place among senators is gay marriage. We know that Mrs. Bush has weighed in.
I'm
ready
not
to weigh in?
No, but thank you for trying.
So Bush managed to celebrate his presidency without having to make news. And while Fox News sent Brett Baer to interview Bush, the network also sent his former press secretary.
Okay, but this is my last question.
Okay.
Who is your biggest fan?
Mila.
No. It's me.
My sweet press secretary.
Dana Perino is a nice person and was a good spokeswoman, but can you imagine the reaction at Fox if MSNBC had said Robert Gibbs to interview former President Obama? Now, last night I put on the tux for the White House Correspondents' Dinner, this annual ritual that has turned into such an overblown spectacle. And President Obama took his usual swipes at the media, including the cable news networks.
I know CNN has taken some knocks lately, but the fact is I admire their commitment to cover all sides of a story, just in case one of them happens to be accurate. Some of my former advisors have switched over to the dark side. For example, David Axelrod now works for MSNBC, which is a nice change of pace since MSNBC used to work for David Axelrod. The History Channel is not here. I guess they were embarrassed about the whole Obama is a devil thing. Of course, that never kept Fox News from showing up.
Let's bring back our panel. Michael Medved, you're a film critic. What does this look like to the rest of the country?
It looks like a bunch of insiders talking inside baseball. The number of ordinary Americans who immediately pick up the reference to the fact that there were some people who thought that the guy who played Satan on the History Channel's theme on the Bible looked like Obama. This is not what the president needs right now. He's at his best when he has the feeling that I can connect with ordinary people. That's why he won the election.
All right. Well,
and the idea of at this moment hobnobbing with a lot of insiders and tuxedos, I don't think it helps the president.
All right. Well, I want to focus on the press corps. Let me ask you, Cenk Uygur. Sarah Palin tweeted this yesterday, and I have to clean it up a little bit. America is working butts off while D.C. blank clowns throw themselves nerd prom, which is the nickname for this annual event. She calls it pathetic. Does it seem pathetic to you that one night a year there's some socializing and a nice dinner with press corps and the administration officials?
Sarah Palin's amazing. You know who I saw at the last White House Correspondents' Dinner? Sarah Palin.
Yeah, she went to some of the parties a few years back.
Yeah, absolutely. I saw her at one of the parties. It's unbelievable. She's such a crazy hypocrite. Now, look, the reality about the White House Correspondents' Dinner is that it should be a lot more awkward than it is. It should be the press who's challenging the government getting together one night and being friendly. Unfortunately, I think they're friendly on many, many nights. I mean, you get a sense of, you know, how the press is not challenging the government enough by who's there and who's not there. I mean, can you imagine if Julian Assange was at the White House Correspondents' Dinner? Now, there's a guy who's actually challenging the government, and he's certainly not invited.
I don't think he got an invite, but certainly a lot of celebrities, Jane Hall did, Amy Poehler, and Nicole Kidman, and people like that. But this has also become a great branding exercise for media corporations. You have these big parties before and afterwards, sponsored by Vanity Fair, Bloomberg, MSNBC. So it's become this whole weekend event for media people.
Well, it has. It's kind of getting closer and closer to the Golden Globes. You know, I think Ed Henry, the head of it, pointed out that they give a lot of scholarships. They made a point of that because they've been criticized. I think one night of hobnobbing is okay, but But I agree, if you're too close.
What about the celebrity aspect? And yeah, it's not like, look, whatever people think of the White House press corps, most of them are not celebs. Most of them work hard. But it's not like one dinner is going to change their view of how they should do their jobs, right?
I don't think so.
This is particularly strong in terms of blending the dividing line between Hollywood and Washington. And I don't think that works well for Hollywood, and I don't think it works well for Washington. The fact that Conan O'Brien was the host, that President Obama had some film clips that were very elegantly prepared. The president was funny. He's always funny at this kind of event.
He's got speechwriters, Michael.
I think there's something a little bit tone deaf right now.
He's got speechwriters. Got to go. Cenk Uygur, once again, Michael Medved and Jane Hall.